playing his 99th NHL game tonight, Jake Sanderson. Raymond down low, Fabry and Larkin. Back for Fabry, puck is loose, they jam away at it. Still loose, Raymond's got it. And oh, and Perron with Larkin down, and they're calling for the trainers as quickly as they can get out there.
He's spread face down, arms on the ice. Good God.
Boy, Dylan Larkin looks in rough shape. Immediately, both teams calling for assistance, and Perron, as you could see, more than a little upset with the way his captain was treated and went down.
Yeah, boy, when stuff like that happens. The front of the net. So there's 21. And there's, and then the collision with 27 white there. And I mean, I don't know if I've ever seen a player down like that. There's, see, Kelly, 27. And he's, I mean, face down with arms out to the side. Gee, that is so terrible. Then he collides with another Ottawa guy going down. And as you mentioned, Ken, he's had the neck problem with the Jamie Benn in Dallas 2 years ago.
Yeah.
See, Fabry's cut two from that last skirmish.
Yikes. 153 locker.
Yeah, 281 points combined between those two.
Cap player down on the ice. It's TJ Oshie in need of attention.
He sure is, and they're hustling over there with Jason Serbus just inside the older blue line. Here's the play coming across the blue line. Here's TJ. Ekholm's going to come across and kabong him. He was unsuspecting, sort of the hand into the face, into the head, too. And because he's unsuspecting, hits the ice very hard. And that's why he's still being looked at here on the ice. Here's Ekholm coming across. There's the push down, and there you see the hard collision with the ice of TJ Oshie.
.209 into the second period. Oshie eyes closed down on the deck.
Ekholm's going to come and give TJ a tap there as he gets up. And getting up very slowly, well, probably head down the runway here to start the second period.
Ekholm whispering to Oshie as TJ makes his wobbly way towards the Capitals dressing room.
Yeah, it looked like he said, I'm sorry.
Aceman has the puck roll away from him. The Lightning have not had a shot on goal in over 10 minutes in this period.
Well, that's how well the Chicago has cleaned things up. Oh, Taylor Hall is shaken up. He can't even get up. Came into the near side wall. It was a pretty big collision. Oh, you can see he is stressed out. Looks like about that right leg. Didn't get a good look at it. It's along the near side boards here, just inside the blue line. Yeah, he's not putting any weight on that.
Yeah, he's in a tough start to the season. Missed four games with a shoulder injury, and now this doesn't look great.
Gets. See if it gets tweaked up. It must get twisted up or something here. Yeah, grabbing his knee. This one might show a little bit better. Aceman taking him out. Oh, yeah. You can see that right leg. Just look at the look on his face there. That leg kind of got dragged behind him, and he couldn't recover it back under his own body there. And you can see the pain on him there, and he can't put any weight on. That's a tough one.
Nylander got it back up for Toronto with Tavares and Robertson. Drop back to Sandin, a hard shot. Thompson is saved.
And Tavares is,
Tavares is down.
Heap.
And he is in.
That is unusual. We'll pull the whistle at this point.
Grabbing his left.
Wow.
Knee. Vegas breaking in 2-on-1. Petrangelo back across. Samsonov makes the save, but at the other end of the ice, John Tavares is down and in distress.
You don't
see guys go down to this degree when a puck hits them in the lower body. When they caught the outside of the knee, sometimes you get a bit of a stint. Yeah, I see him grabbing maybe outside of the left knee there. But he is in some serious discomfort. Sandin tees one up. Yeah, I think it's him right on the outside of the left knee. Can be a bit of a stinger situation. Oof. But he was writhing in pain.
That was a 97 mile an hour shot.
He's finally been helped back to his feet. No weight on that left leg. It's amazing this doesn't happen more often. The way the pucks go flying in there 100 miles an hour, but he's not anywhere near to being right.
He's in against Bobrovsky and shoots, and Bobrovsky with a huge stop. Evans went to the end boards and he's down.
And he's
Weegar
hurt.
Is upset because the Panthers were going the other way.
Yeah,
and the Panthers are irate that they blew the whistle despite the injury being all the way back behind the play.
Lose control of that puck, and here Evans fires the puck. Bobrovsky makes the save, lost his edge, and look at, boom, no way to protect yourself. And then Edmondson goes after Weegar.
Well, the Panthers are upset because obviously Evans, and we hope he's okay, still down behind the net.
Buffer that blow, and usually when that happens, it's either a shoulder injury or something with the upper body. Yeah, he is shaken up.
A check from Roy. Heavy hit delivered by Duhaime.
Great clean hit, getting in on the forecheck, Duhaime. It seems like he's got his fingerprints all over every game, whether it's an assist like the other night or it's a big hit.
And here, Edler a little slow to his feet after the hit by Duhaime.
And you never want to see anybody hurt, but Duhaime just, you know, getting in on the court, on the forecheck and finishing his check, and Edler got off a little bit off balance, and he just finished his check. So playing for the Vancouver Canucks, it looked like maybe his left ankle or something maybe got trapped underneath him when he went to the ice, but guy's a warrior. He's a hard-nosed player, and you hate to see that.
Arizona with Nash trying to lay it in front. It slides right to the goal, and it's directed the corner. Anderson might have got a stick on that one to help steer it away. And the Sabres pick it up, but we get a whistle with a crowd down, and Butcher is down and hurt in the Sabres zone. It does not look good.
No, he's not. He's laying there, and he's not moving. He's waiting for a little help there. Maybe here. Well, he gets falling down right there, and Coyote player gets tangled up in his feet. See right there, he had both skates underneath the Coyote player that went into the corner there, 36. See if anything from, oh, that left leg looked like it might have got caught underneath. And that's what the trainer's looking at right now. D might not get much ice time, and if Will Butcher is out and not able to come back into this game, then that changes things for him right there in the first 3 minutes of this hockey game. Once again, something else he has to deal with.
Milano, a little lead behind pass for Shattenkirk, gets it back and rips it right on. Husso down, thinks he's on top of it, and he will get the whistle.
Oh my. Isaac Lundestrom pulled that puck around the goaltender, tried to jam it in the short side, and the Blues defense bailed out their goaltender. Watch this play. Here comes Lundestrom, he's around the goaltender, he's gonna stuff it in. It's Marco Scandella, strong on the stick. That keeps that puck from going in the short side. That difficulty for the goaltender there is that the initial shot hits Mayhew, so it doesn't get through to him, and Jerry Mayhew is still down on the ice, being attended to by athletic trainer Joe Huff, and now being helped off the ice.
Yeah, not putting any weight on that left leg. That's unfortunate.